We're going to be shooting a promo for an upcoming Carpe Ludos show called Blackout. A little bit of a snag, though. There's a winter weather advisory.
Could be a disaster.
Could be a disaster.
Still not worried. Still not worried.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go!
From Carpe Ludos, and welcome to another CL Live, Carpe Ludos Live, live stream. Today we got an extra special one for you. Some of you may know, some of you have been following us closely. We're actually working on you'd call it maybe an audio drama, a podcast, a narrative audio experience from our friend named Brad Voighton. It's called Blackout. It's a cyberpunk series, and it's honestly going to be super cool. We've been having so much fun developing the series with Brad, seeing what all, all his promotional material and all that stuff, and you know, all the little tidbits that we've been getting from him have been like super amazing. So, before we jump into playing some Star Wars Battlefront II, which is a way better game than it used to be, let me tell you, oh my gosh, this game is actually legitimately great now. Seriously, go play it; it's amazing. But before we do that, I actually compiled a little bit of some behind the scenes video. Maybe not the most complete of a video that I've ever made, but we're actually going to take a look at that right now before we jump in and just talk a little bit about the series. All right, let's do this. Okay, so here's the situation. In about 6 hours, we're going to be shooting a promo for an upcoming Carpe Ludos show called Blackout. Now, I don't think we've talked about Blackout on this channel in an official capacity so far, maybe on one of the live streams, but you know what, we'll just announce it right now. We're doing a show called Blackout. It's a narrative podcast created by my good friend, Brad Voighton. It's gonna be super cool. It's like cyberpunk themed. So today we're actually shooting a trailer, a kind of trailer. It's not the official trailer. It's kind of more like a fun teaser trailer with a lot of sweet CG effects. A little bit of a snag though. There's a winter weather advisory in place for tonight starting pretty much now, starting an hour ago, all the way until like 11, and they say like 2 to 4 inches of snow. Now I'm from Ohio. A lot of the actors are from Ohio. Two to four inches is nothing. It's fine, right? But the thing is, the people of New York, New Jersey, bless their hearts, do not know how to drive in any amount of snow. That could be a potential problem. But we're all taking public transit, so it should, in theory, be fine. But you never know. With New York, sometimes, even in the face of disaster, everything runs normally, and sometimes a small amount of precipitation ends the entire grid. So I guess we'll see. All right, so I'm looking at the radar here. You can see this giant just sheet of snow rolls through. And that's not even the end of this diagram is when we start shooting. So could be a disaster.
Could be a disaster, but hopefully it won't be.
All right, it's getting snowier. The courtyard is covered. People are in coats. Still not worried.
All right, so it's pretty snowy. There's some accumulation, but we're still on for the shoot, so let's just hope the bus comes, because if it doesn't come, I'm taking the ferry. So the bus came, that's good. Now we just need to get from Midtown to Fundy, which means taking a train. Hopefully they're running. So I'm here at the location a little early, just scouting it out. It's a lot different than the last time I saw it, but it's pretty cool. So it'll work. And it's got a bunch of sweet lights, and I'm actually really excited because it looks way cooler than it used to. Now to rendezvous with the actors. So one of the big challenges of shooting New York for Chicago is that, especially down in here in Financial District, Chicago's built on pretty much a perfect grid. And New York is too in Midtown, but down in FIDI, the streets are absolute crazy. It's just like a, you can accidentally walk in circles. I've done it before. It's not great. So right now I'm just kind of walking around waiting for actors and also scouting out locations that kind of look like Chicago. I've been to Chicago a few times and I love the downtown area, I love the Loop area. And right now we're in Battery Park in New York and we're kind of getting some similar skyline views. Luckily the snow is saving us a lot here and that a lot of it's kind of fogged and shrouded out. So those with super keen eyes probably won't be able to tell that this is actually New York City and not Chicago. But it's one of the big hurdles that we're dealing with. But thankfully the snow, in addition to looking super cinematic, it also is saving our butts. So thank you, snow. The other great thing about this snow is that there's no one here. Usually at night, even in the wintertime, Battery Park is like, there's a fair amount of people. It's dead. It is dead. I'm the only person here. And I can talk to this tiny rectangle without any fear of looking like a weirdo. So we just wrapped shooting. I ended up not recording any of it because just as we started, just as we met everyone, it started to rain. I don't know if you can tell right now, it's raining. What used to be snow on the ground is now slush. It sucks. So now I'm going back to get an HDRI for the CG stuff, and then I'm getting the heck out of here. Yeah, so it pretty much ended there. I recorded another clip, but unfortunately, with the GoPro audio, it was bad. I mean, I don't know if for a vlogging setup, I need like an external microphone or something. You know, the GoPro is perfect because it's so small, but at the same time, ugh, the audio can get so bad when it's windy. Woof. But anyway, pretty much after that, I just like sat on the train, just like dripping wet, and people were looking at me like, what happened to this guy? I looked like hell, to put it nicely. I looked really bad. So the shoot itself actually went really, really, really well. Basically, what we're doing is we're shooting kind of like a fun CG kind of teaser trailer. Brad's actually working right now on a trailer that is more of an official trailer, kind of something that adheres more to his vision. This one that I'm doing is kind of more like a fun glitz glam, you know, throw glitter in your face kind of trailer. And it's fun to work together with Brad because Brad has developed, I mean, he sent me a whole bunch of just like information and backstory, and there's just pages and pages of lore that he's developed with this show that occurs in Chicago after like this big blackout. And I won't talk too much more about like the plot and stuff there because a lot of it's still, you know, under development. Some of the stuff I saw was still TBD, so I don't want to say something that might not necessarily be true, but based on everything that I've heard and like some demo episodes, I mean, it's sounding super cool. And immediately Abu and I were super jazzed about the project when we first heard about it. So that's super cool. And we're both like super excited to see the show lift up off the ground. I don't have an exact release date yet. We're obviously looking at like scheduling and stuff, but it should be out. I mean, it's definitely gonna be out this spring at some point. We're still, you know, talking with Brad about like production and stuff like that. But I am super excited. The shoot itself was great. A good friend Logan, who is a friend of the channel, I'm sure you've seen Logan before if you've ever watched this channel. Shout out to Logan. You're my homie. I love you. We all love you. yeah, Logan came out and featured as one of the gang members and a gang that features in the show. So that was super cool. Whoa! Ooh, got him. Man, this got intense real fast. Whoa. Nice. Doing well. Throw up a turret and back out so I can talk again. Okay. So, what was I saying? Oh, yeah. And then the video obviously starred my other good friend, David. Nice. Got him. You gotta be kidding me. They're making it too easy. So my short is starring my good friend David. If you've seen my short film, Those Who Came Before, which is done with its festival run, so I guess there's no like legal things I have to worry about talking about it. But he starred in that. He's a good friend of mine, and he's an incredible actor. So he came out and donated his time. He's in the big leagues now, working in New York. So we went to school together, just how we know each other. So it was honestly super great working with him again. Just when you work with people who are super talented, it's just, it's just amazing. You just get this like night and day difference. with your product. So huge shout out to David. Thank you so much for helping us out on that, man. It's going to be amazing. I will say, though, I did not miss being, you know, back when I was in film school, I would be the producer, director, DP of literally everything. Ooh, grenade! And that sucked, I'm not gonna lie. So doing it again, it was fun to be run and gun, but there was just, like, afterwards, I was like, oh, there's so many shots I missed, and, like, because when you're, you know, the producer, director, casting, costumes, literally everything, you tend to miss out on some stuff, which is always a bummer. But you know what, you always make the best with what you have. There's so many shoots that went so much more poorly that turned out pretty good, so I'm not, oof. Ugh, got iced by those filthy rebels. But yeah, it went well, more or less. I am excited to, you know, incorporate some more CG stuff. If any of you saw the Join Us trailer that we did a while back, we did quite a bit of CG on that. And actually, it was entirely CG, now that I think about it. Maybe a little bit of 2D animation work at the end. But it's fun to kind of incorporate that into the Carpe Ludos channel. And we're all kind of using our real-life work experience to make this channel something super awesome. What if I put a turret here? Oh, well. Oof. Yeah, I gotta tell you, my friends... if you like Star Wars, this game is amazing. Like, it had a lot of problems at launch, obviously. But, they fixed most of it. Especially with, like, the new co-op modes. It's just, like, it's all so good. It just, like, feels extremely Star Wars. Which is, oh, man. That guy got me good. There's no other game out there that just captures that, like, Star Wars feeling. I mean, they have, like, all the practical effects that you see in Star Wars, the original trilogy, they have in here. And, I mean, DICE just was super faithful to the movies. And it just feels like you're running around in the movies. So, huge, if you like Star Wars, this is the game to play. If you're going to get one Star Wars game in 2020, get this game, because it's great. Fantastic. Highly recommend. You know, I really would have liked to play a Cyberpunk game, talking about our upcoming Cyberpunk series. It's a huge bummer that Cyberpunk 2077 is delayed. But obviously, if it means better working conditions for the workers, which it doesn't necessarily mean, but... In a perfect world, a game being delayed means that the... they can see me. In a perfect world, a game being delayed means that the workers have a better quality of life. I know that's not necessarily true, but... We do love a game developer here at Carpe Ludos, and if they need an extra 6 months, well, dadgummit, we're gonna wait an extra 6 months, if that's what it takes. Obviously, The Witcher 3, which we played last week, check out that live stream, by the way. It was a great game, maybe a perfect game, depending on who you ask. Oh, that guy's gonna get behind our lines. So yeah, I had a few other Cyberpunk options to play for this, but I was like, what the heck? I've been playing a lot of Star Wars. The Rise of Skywalker really made me, gave me a hankering for some Star Wars Battlefront, and boy, does this game deliver. Ooh, sneaky. You know, I gotta put this turret up somewhere high. It's really gonna annoy those bad guys. By bad guys, I mean the Rebel Alliance. Like right here. Or here. Or here. Got it. Alright, I should probably get on the point. Help my stormtrooper bros. Whoa! 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 You know, all things considered, that went really well. Ooh, can I be a hero? No, we'll wait on that. But yeah, speaking of previous live streams, if you have not... Oh, is Darth Vader up there? Oh, I got Yoda. I pot shotted Yoda. Oh my god, Yoda and Darth Vader? That's amazing. Oh, this game is great. It's just so silly. Whoa, whoa. We're actually gonna lose if I don't start doing better. Maybe I should be a hero, actually. Maintain our presence at the rebel camp. It'll no. Shortly. We can do it, I believe. Yeah, but last week we did a Carpe Ludos live about The Witcher. Oh, nice job. Abu, our head of content, obviously is hard at work right now on his Winds Howling podcast, which is honestly amazing. After I had listened to the first episode after Abu and I did that live stream. Do not sneak up on my friends. Oh, Keegan, are you going to miss every shot? You are, aren't you? Oof. Anyway, after Abu and I had that, I went ahead and watched the Witcher Netflix show. And I texted him and I was like, dude, the series does not work without this show. Like, if you don't have someone with you telling you exactly what's happening in the show, like, you're gonna be lost. Especially if you're not, if you're someone who isn't super familiar with the Witcher franchise. But look, I played all of The Witcher 2, all of The Witcher 3, minus one expansion. Oh, we are in the weeds now. We got 10 boys left. Oof. All right, we're in. Yeah, I've played all of The Witcher 2. I played all of The Witcher 3. And watching the show, I had no idea what was going on. Like, absolutely no idea. So I literally went back and I listened to every episode of the podcast that was out at the time to help me figure out what was even happening. And honestly, like, I probably would not have even enjoyed the show had I not had the podcast. And that's not just me saying it as, like, being affiliated with Lore Party and Winds Howling. It's just straight up, like, it's the only way to watch the show. So yeah, if there is a more glowing recommendation for the Winds Howling podcast, I can't think of one, because it's necessary if you want to watch The Witcher, full stop. But yeah, that being said, been having a lot of fun watching The Witcher. I gotta watch a new show this week while I'm working. Maybe I'll go back and hit up Chernobyl. Maybe I will. Oof, that was a big hit. Thermal Imploder. Oh, it's Chewbacca. All right, if we're gonna break out the heroes, now's the time. Oh, Bossk. Yes. I don't like Bossk as a character because he's not really a character, but oh, he's a sweet hero. He's got some dope skills. All right, boys, hold that line. Go, 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 go. Oh, we got him. Look, I can see through walls. This is an amazing hero. This is also the best place to have boss, because it's a very sniper-heavy stage. Whoa. 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 Ow. Oh, man. I'm stuck. All right, I'm gonna recharge health here. Yeah, been enjoying The Witcher. Probably gonna check out Chernobyl or Watchmen. I hear is amazing. Still haven't seen it. Really need to catch up on all my non-Netflix TV shows. Peace. Oh, I got cocky. You know, as much as I've been talking up Bossk here, I have not been doing well with him. To be fair, my team's got a poosh. Bossk level 5? Am I really that inexperienced? Oh, we're actually close to overriding this bad boy. That's ours, right? Yeah. Ooh, sneaky snakes. Oh, am I really gonna get wrecked right now? Oof. Woof. Gotta regen that health. Stat. We have control of the gate. Hunt down the rebels, then march on the main structure. Quickly. Man, these guys are good. The rebels can't defeat us, but they can still wipe the databanks we came for. Get in there now. I'm sure this looks great on your screen, just this inverted blue. Got him. Oh, the Emperor. Whoa. Whoa. Where are they at? I see you. Oh, is that Chew Broccoli over there? Woof. All right, we got this right. Oh, no. Ugh. I got completely wrecked. I almost have enough points for another hero, though. No, I should probably leave that to the pros. Grab, like, a flame trooper. I should grab Bossk again. At some point, they'll do a little refresh, and I can grab a new hero. And by new hero, I mean the same hero. Oh, here we go. All right. Let's go. I'm not doing well. For those of you who are good at this game, I very much apologize. I have good days and bad days, and this appears to be a bad day. But hey, that's okay, because I'm having an absolute blast, let me tell you. They've also done a great job in this game incorporating... woo! Man, these guys are so good. Oh, it's because Chewbacca's over there. They did a good job incorporating, like, a lot of stuff from different movies. So, like, this trooper, I think, debuted in Rogue One, Star Wars Story. Beginning command center download. What does this do? Get him. Oh, I think that's him. Give me revenge. I missed every shot. Oh, Ray, get out of here. I didn't feel good. That hurt me in the guts. All right, looks like we got one command center down. You know what? I'm just gonna jump in. Gotta be a specialist. Oh no! Humiliating defeat. The rebels have erased everything. Well, that's all right. Oh, my frame rate. What is happening? I've got a beast of a machine. So I gotta figure out what setting is like throwing this off. Because I should have flawless frame rates. Oh, that Lando skin is so cool. Dope. All right. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. This is a slightly abbreviated stream, obviously. I hope you guys are all excited for Blackout. I will be showing... we'll be showing hopefully more. You'll get some trailers coming up soon. Obviously, my trailer will be coming out at some point in the near future. But keep it locked to this channel. Keep it locked to the Carpe Ludos Twitter and Instagram for the most recent updates. And we do these streams maybe every other week. I don't know how regular it's going to be, but we'll be doing more of them for sure. And it won't just be me. So if you're tired of hearing my voice, don't worry at all. All right. Well, that's all I got for you guys today. Thank you so much. Have a great week, and I'll catch you next time. Thanks.